We're here to break the news that it's not official yet, but Addison Reed, it looks like he's headed to the Boston Red Sox for three minor league relievers. The names: Jamie Callahan, Gerson Batista, and Steven Nogosek. Obviously, we're not experts on, we can't pretend to be experts on those three guys. They're all supposed to be power arms in the minor leagues. Jamie Callahan, the closest to the big leagues in AAA. The other two are single A. But again, Addison Reed being shipped to Boston, we are hearing, and it's not official yet. We'll let you know if it does become official while we're here on the air. And Daily News baseball writer John Harper, we're happy to have him join us on the phone. Harp, your first initial reaction to this deal?
Well, it sounds like they've done well in getting what they need. Power arms in their system. That's been a glaring weakness as far as their bullpen goes. And that's been, I know from talking to Mets people, that's been one of the things they really wanted to try and beef up here at the deadline with the chance to trade some of these guys. You know, they did a nice job in bringing Ramos in to protect themselves for next year, and now they make the most of the Reed deal. We'll see. I mean, you never know. These guys weren't rated really highly in the Red Sox system. I think 18 was the highest. So, you know, you're taking a chance on what they think will be guys who will develop. In terms of power arms, that's what you want. That's what you hope for in the bullpen. And it looks like, you know, they have a chance to get some help there anyway in the coming years.
Yeah, it's an interesting deal. These are all, as Harp mentioned, not high prospects in their system, but they are all top 30 prospects in the Boston Red Sox system. And we've had this discussion over the past couple of weeks, Harp, as we've been hearing that Addison Reed might be traded. We didn't know how much Sandy Alderson was wanting in terms of a deal. He is a very good back-end reliever, but he's not Andrew Miller, and it's not an Andrew Miller-type return for Sandy Alderson and company.
No, it's not. That was an exception, and partly because, Miller, just his status, as well as the fact that he was under control for two more years. For rentals, other than Aroldis Chapman last year, you rarely get the real high-end prospects here. So, you know, we'll see. I think the biggest thing is that they're taking advantage of this opportunity. You have to do it. Reed's going to be a free agent. You have to get what you can. The Red Sox, I'm told, were aggressive. It wasn't like they were the only team bidding at Reed. There was a lot of interest in Reed. The Red Sox, I think the bottom line here is the Mets went for quantity as much as quality, because talk to them, their executives, and they feel like a lot of times, you know, not everybody's going to pan out, but, if you get enough of them, you're going to get somebody that's going to work out. So I think that was part of the thought here, too. It sounds like the Red Sox are willing to give up more in terms of quantity than other teams.
And, Harp, if you look at, generally speaking, Addison Reed, Sandy Alderson brought him in. This was a guy that had been DFA'd, released, had been in the minor leagues, and Sandy brought this guy in and turned him into a really good trade chip. But not just that, he's really helped this team. He's been a really top 10 reliever in the National League the last couple of years. How much credit do you think Sandy Alderson deserves for bringing him in and now getting something pretty good back in return for him?
Yeah, this is in total, this is really a nice deal, because, as you said, Reed, at the time, nobody thought much of him. It looked like he had peaked maybe already and wasn't getting people out. The Mets brought him in and turned him around. Talking to Reed about it, you know, it was mostly about finding his slider again and being able to command that pitch. That's the nature of relievers, though. We see it all the time. They're kind of up and down. The Mets took a chance on him. They got the best of him, and now they're trading him. That's what you hope to do as an executive. So you do. You got to give Sandy Alderson credit for doing this.
And a good point just now on Twitter from Mike Puma of The Post, who says the Mets now have acquired five relievers, four of them minor leaguers, since Thursday. So clearly the point that Harp's making is true. They're trying to bolster up the arms and the pitching depth in this organization. All right, so moving forward, we have several hours until the 4 o'clock deadline. Harp, Asdrubal Cabrera, Curtis Granderson, and Jay Bruce. Do you think the Mets are done, or do you think there's a move yet to be made?
Well, I think they're going to be out there looking still. I still think there's a chance Cabrera goes, because there are teams that could use him as a versatile guy, switch hitter, all that. He has a good reputation in the game, despite that, you know, the trade request and all that. And I still think somewhere, maybe at the last hour, some team will say, hey, we could really use Jay Bruce. I mean, the guy's having a good year. Power obviously isn't as valued as it was a few years ago. Everybody's hitting home runs now. But he's still a guy. I actually thought the Red Sox might be a team where he would work, because they're last in the American League at home runs. They need power. They're trying to play catch-up with the Yankees now. But it just doesn't seem like Still, nobody has really come forward, and it doesn't seem like there's much of a market for him. But I still think there's a chance somebody like that could go at the last minute if a team sees an opportunity to get value.
And one of the points I keep seeing, Harp, is something that is interesting and you don't think of, especially around this time of year before the trade deadline. It's the non-waiver trade deadline. We get into August. These guys could be very valuable. Do you think that Sandy Alderson's thinking, all right, other than Reed, all these guys can get through waivers. I might be able to get more if there are injuries around the league and teams get more desperate, think maybe they're one bat or arm away as we go into August?
That's always possible. You know, Bruce, with his chance, I would think, with his salary, he would get through waivers. And, yeah, all it takes is one key injury, and that becomes a need for a team. So I think that could be part of it. But, it tends to be at this time, right, at the deadline where teams really seize the opportunity to do what they can for their teams, and they're not really thinking about that. But an injury could change everything. So, yeah, I mean, it's possible. And the way the collective bargaining agreement is now, you're just not getting as much by holding on to a guy and getting a draft choice for him. So that's why teams are going to be more aggressive in chopping these guys right up until August 31st.
And, Harp, this might be a stretch. The Yankees have already made a couple moves, but Addison Reed is a good pickup for them. They already have one of the best closers in baseball, if not the best, in Craig Kimbrell in the ninth inning. This is a good move for the Red Sox, and the Yankees and Red Sox really right now are letting each other get away with mistakes at the top of the AL East. Do you think by any chance this motivates the Yankees to go out and further motivate them to make this Sonny Gray move?
It could, but I mean, I've been told that they are very motivated, that they have really taken stock in the last week or so with the team getting hot. And the term I use today in the Daily News, I was quoting somebody in the organization, is they feel like they can seize the moment here. They think the division is there to be taken, and that Gray could be the piece that really gets them over the top. There's risk there because of his injury history, and it seems like maybe it's going to go right down to the wire with as far as what Billy Beane wants and what Cashman was willing to give up. But I think they're very motivated from talking to their people. They feel like there's really an opportunity to win that division now.
Daily News baseball columnist John Harper. Harp, we always appreciate you stopping by and talking to us, and thanks for doing this today.
Okay, thanks, Doug.